Do you need a nice mainboard for your home server? I'm rebuilding my home server that is mainly meant for file storage. So I bought myself the ASUS P8B75V mainboard. Its features are energy saving, USB 3.0 boost support, network eye control, UEFI BIOS and GPU boost. It also has AMD Crossfire technology, is Windows 8 ready and has Intel Technology Smart Connect. The socket is Intel LGA 1155 and the chipset Intel B75 Express. Furthermore, it offers support for 32GB RAM as well as integrated graphics. In the box are two serial ATA cables, a manual and a quick start guide. The board itself is packed into a non-static bag. On the board you get PS2 ports for keyboard and mouse, DVI and VGA output, two USB 3.0 ports plus two on the front panel, four USB 2.0 ports plus four on the front panel, a Realtek gigabit network port and standard audio ports from a Realtek chip. Your power supply needs to have 24 pins and an 8-pin EATX 12-volt plug. Additionally, there are three PCI slots which I needed for my old controller cards, one PCI Express 2.0 16 slot, two PCI Express 2.01 slot, one GPU boost port, one ATA 6 gigabit per second port and five more that have 3 gigabytes per second. The bridge cooler has a plastic foil attached that you should take off against overheating. When you install the CPU, make sure you keep the plastic cover attached as you flip back the lever. The CPU itself has a marked edge that needs to be oriented appropriately. When closing the casing, pay attention that it slides under the screw. Finally, remove the plastic cap. The four DDR3 memory ports are coded. If you install pairs, only use the same color. Instead of starting with the slot closest to the processor, the manual tells you to use the next one. As a big cooler can totally block access to the memory ports, you should install the DIMMs first. I installed CentOS Linux, which is a Red Hat clone, and it works just fine. This is not a gamer top-of-the-edge high-performance motherboard. I chose it for the amount of card slots that allow for more hard disk controllers and network adapters. So it's a reasonable option for your home server or probably part-time gaming computer. Which mainboard would you have chosen for your home server? Put it in the comment section. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to have a look at my other videos. If you like, subscribe and follow me on your favorite social media to stay informed about the latest news and uploads.